Did you know that cerebral palsy is the most common motor disability during childhood? Cerebral palsy refers to a group of disorder that affects a person's motor ability, balance, and posture. To better understand cerebral palsy, we can break down the word into cerebral and palsy. Cerebral refers to any condition related to the brain, and palsy refers to muscle weakness or any other problem related to using your muscles. Cerebral palsy can be caused by abnormal brain development or brain damage that affects muscle control in individuals. The symptoms of cerebral palsy can vary from person to person. A person with mild cerebral palsy usually has slight difficulty with walking and may not need any special equipment to help them. In contrast, a person with severe cerebral palsy most often needs special equipment to help them with walking or may not be able to walk at all. However, all cerebral palsy patients have problems with movement and posture, with most patients also having conditions such as seizures, muscle and joint pain, and problems related to vision, hearing, or speech. Cerebral palsy can be classified based on type of motor disorder. The three most common forms of cerebral palsy are spastic, dyskinetic, and ataxic. Spastic cerebral palsy is the most common, with 80% of people with cerebral palsy having this form. Spastic cerebral palsy refers to muscle stiffness in your legs, arms, or all four limbs. Dyskinetic cerebral palsy usually causes uncontrollable movement in your arms and legs, making it difficult to walk and sit. This form of cerebral palsy can also affect your face and tongue, making it difficult to swallow and talk. Finally, ataxic cerebral palsy results in difficulty with balance and coordination. This can affect your ability to complete different tasks such as writing, picking up an object, or walking.
So, what is physiotherapy and how can it be used to help treat cerebral palsy? Physiotherapy is a branch of healthcare that focuses on the diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of physical impairments and disabilities. Physiotherapists use a variety of techniques to help patients restore their physical function, mobility, and strength, as well as to alleviate pain and prevent further injury. In the case of cerebral palsy, physiotherapy can help patients improve their mobility and prevent movement problems from getting worse. For example, physiotherapists can use exercises to help improve muscle strength, flexibility, and range of motion. They can also use techniques such as stretching to help reduce pain and stiffness. They can also help improve balance and coordination skills, which can be challenging for people with this condition. In addition, physiotherapists can teach individuals with cerebral palsy how to use assistive devices such as braces, walkers, and wheelchairs.
As mentioned earlier, the most common types of cerebral palsy are spastic, dyskinetic, and ataxic. The benefits and goals of physiotherapy can vary depending on the type of cerebral palsy. As mentioned earlier, spastic cerebral palsy is the most common type. Dedicated physiotherapy for spastic CP utilizes stretches as the main physical component to help relieve muscle tension and reduce stiffness and jerky movement. Meanwhile, in dyskinetic cerebral palsy, physiotherapy will utilize a strength training focused approach, which aims to restore some of the lost control of muscle movement through increasing muscle tone. Lastly, physiotherapy for ataxic cerebral palsy aims to improve gait and balance problems faced by patients through a combination of different techniques such as gait analysis, strength, and posture training. Additionally, through physiotherapy, several other conditions that are associated with cerebral palsy can be improved upon, such as scoliosis, which is the abnormal curvature in the spine, pelvic issues such as pelvic inclination, which is the protrusion of the pelvis either forward or backward, and knee, wrist, or hand deformities, such as the abnormal flexing or straining of these joints. Physiotherapy for cerebral palsy patients will focus on improving muscle tone either by incorporating flexibility training for overtoned muscles or strength exercises for undertoned muscles. Furthermore, physiotherapy for cerebral palsy patients will assist in improving posture and walking.
So, what should you expect in physiotherapy? To help us with this, we consulted Asha Chowdhury, a physiotherapist at Trillium Health Partners. Each patient with cerebral palsy will have different needs, so a physiotherapist will conduct an in-depth assessment by first examining the patient's medical history and general health, including assessing various body systems, cognition, and level of consciousness. It is also important to assess the physiological and psychological needs of the patient, as well as their learning ability. When it comes to assessing children, more information, such as developmental milestones relative to age, as well as the mother's pre- and postnatal health is needed. A physiotherapist will also conduct a series of standardized tests to assess various aspects of the patient's movement, muscle tone, spasticity, functional mobility, and motor skills. Patient and family-centered care and goal setting are also important aspects of creating an intervention plan. It is important to involve the patient in setting their own goals and to respect their values, beliefs, and preferences. And for optimal outcomes during an intervention, a supportive family and community are essential. Physiotherapy needs can also differ between children and adults. The focus for adults is typically pain management, whereas the focus for children is more on achieving functional goals and supporting their movement development. During treatment, physiotherapists may provide or recommend various mobility aids, such as walkers and wheelchairs. A wide range of therapeutic interventions is also used in managing cerebral palsy. Some popular approaches include passive and active stretching, which can help improve mobility and flexibility. Passive stretching involves using an external force and assistance to stretch tight muscles, whereas active stretching involves stretching that is initiated and maintained by the patient. Treadmill walking exercises can also be used to improve walking functions and gait, which is a person's manner of walking. Individuals with cerebral palsy may walk with an abnormal gait due to muscle tightness. Improving an abnormal gait pattern is essential, as poor form can drastically restrict a person's movement and lead to the development of chronic pain. During these exercises, the patient can practice walking on a treadmill with the support of a harness if needed. This exercise can help improve functions such as walking speed, endurance, and form. Physiotherapists can also use strength training to treat and manage cerebral palsy. This approach involves a physiotherapist determining which exercises should be used to improve the function of a patient's weak or underused muscles based on a functional assessment. They guide the patient to perform these exercises safely, ensuring that the correct muscles are being targeted. Strength training can help improve balance, flexibility, posture, and muscle strength in cerebral palsy patients, making it easier for them to be active.
In summary, physiotherapy can be a valuable treatment option for individuals with cerebral palsy. Physiotherapists can help to improve physical function, mobility, and strength, as well as to alleviate pain and prevent further injury. If you or a loved one has cerebral palsy, it may be worth considering physiotherapy as part of your treatment plan.